Hey guys, it's Vignesh from CodeAndroid. In this video, we'll see how to read existing database in Android. To demonstrate this, I already created a project. Here, I have a launcher activity. Inside, I have a button. On click of the button, I'm opening the main activity. In main activity, I have an object of DB handler. Using that, we can read the table. The table contains ID and number as its columns. Here, while creating the table itself, I'm inserting 1 to 1000 into database using a transaction, because bulk insertion will take less time using a transaction. In the main activity, I'm using a recycler view to display all the data. So, I created a method called getAllData, which will read all the data from the table and returning it. Using DB handler class, calling getAllData and storing it into a value called numberList, and the adapter reads the value from the numberList. Inside onBindViewHolder method, setting textViewText as p1th item from the numberList. I have another textView in the child layout where I want to show whether the number is odd number or even number, but which is defined by the calculation which is happening here. Now I want to add a column inside the table itself, in which I want to store whether the number is odd number or not. To do that, we need to update the existing database. If the app is getting installed for the first time, then we need to have that column. So, I'm adding a column called isOddNumber, which is a type of integer. While inserting the data also, we want to update the column. So, I'm adding isOddNumber equals to number modulus of 2. If the app is getting installed on an older device which has older version of database, then we need to update the database here. If old version equals to 1 and new version equals to 2, then we want to update the database. If we have more data in the database, then the update might take longer time. Because of that, ANR might happen. To avoid that, I am going to use an async task for doing the update. Class updateDB, which extends async task, inside passing void void void. Let's implement the members. For doing the update, we need the database object, so I'm taking database object as a parameter. I want to show a progress bar while doing the update, so I'm taking the context also as a parameter for the async task. Inside overriding onPreExecute and onPostExecute for showing and hiding the progress bar. Creating a dialog object inside async task, let init var dialog is a type of alert dialog. Inside onPreExecute, we'll create an alert dialog builder and setting the custom view as dialog layout. Finally, creating the dialog object from the builder by calling create and storing it into dialog. Now we can show the dialog by calling show method. In onPostExecute, we need to hide the dialog. So I'm checking if dialog is initialized, then calling dialog.dismiss. We'll call this async task inside here by passing DB and context. Here database might be null, so I'm checking if database is not null, then calling the async task. We need to do the database update here. We need to return void, so I'm making it nullable void and returning null. To do the update, we need to add the column first, so I'm altering the table by adding the column. Alter table and table name. Here we need to give number list. We want to add a column, so add column is odd number is a type of integer. Now we need to execute this query using execute SQL method. After executing this query, the table will have new column. Before that, we need to read all the datas. Value get all data equals to select star from number list. Executing this query using a raw query method and storing it into a value called query result. After using the query result, we need to close it. So calling close on query result. Between here, we need to read the data from query result. So I'm copying the code from get all data and pasting it here. Now we read all the data from the table and stored into result. After that, we are altering the table. Now we need to update the new column. Here also, I'm going to use transaction for reducing the execution time. Using a for loop, I'm reading the result array. Inside creating a content values, inside we want to put only the newly added column. CV.put is odd number, result.number modulus of 2. If you want to give explicitly, you can give like this. Result of number modulus of 2 double equal to 0. Now we want to update this column. db.update, inside we need to pass table name, content values, where class and where arguments. For where class, I'm passing id equals to question mark. For where arguments, I'm passing array of result of i.id.toString. After updating all the datas, we need to make the transaction as successful. db.setTransactionSuccessful. Finally, we need to call endTransaction. If we are not calling endTransaction, then the transaction will not get committed. So don't forget to call endTransaction. To simulate the delay, I'm setting 10 seconds delay using a thread. You can see here old version is equals to 1 and new version is equals to 2. Then we are calling the DB update. So I'm changing the DB version as 2. Also adding is odd number in the number object. In get all data, we need to get is odd number from table. So I'm getting is odd number as an integer and comparing it with 1. Now we need to use this flag inside our recycler view. We are using the database here only. Because of async task, we will read the database before it updates. To avoid that, I am creating an object of DB handler and calling a dummy function called getWritableDatabase, where I am simply returning the writable database. Now, the dialog will not allow us to press the button until it completes the database update. Now we'll launch the application. You can see it's showing the dialog. We have given the delay as 10 seconds, so it's showing the dialog for 10 seconds. On click of go to list, you can see the odd number and even number is showing properly, which means the data is updated into database properly. Like this, we can update the database using an async task. If we have more versions, we can have else if here, where we can check old version is equals to 1 and new version is equals to 3. Like this, we can have multiple conditions and we can do the update accordingly. That's all for this video, guys. If you want to support me, you can do that by becoming a patron at patreon.com/codeandroid. Hope you like it. I will see you in my next video. Have a nice day.